To evaluate this expression, let's change the rational exponent into a radical expression. So remember that the numerator is the exponent and the denominator is the index number. So let's rewrite it. That'll be the third root of 27 raised to the second power. So we're going to first evaluate the radical, and the third root of 27 is 3. And then we have 3 squared, which of course equals 9. So 9 is our final answer. Let's look at the next one. So we're going to change this rational exponent into a radical expression. So we've got the third root of 8 over 27 raised to the second power. So let's work in the parentheses first. So we have the third root of 8 divided by the third root of 27. All of that squared. So now the third root of 8 is 2, and the third root of 27 is 3, all of it squared. And now we're going to square the top and bottom. So we have 2 squared over 3 squared, which will give us a final answer of 4 over 9. Let's change this rational exponent into a radical expression. Again, remember that the denominator is your index and the numerator is your exponent. So we're going to write that as the square root of 36 raised to the third power. So let's work in the parentheses first. So the square root of 36 is 6 raised to the third power. And now 6 to the third power equals 216. Let's change this rational exponent into a radical expression. So we have the fourth root of 16 raised to the third power. So let's work in the parentheses first. The fourth root of 16 equals 2, and we still have the third power here, and then 2 to the third power equals 8. Let's change this rational exponent to a radical expression, and as a reminder, remember that the denominator is your index number and the numerator is your exponent. So we have the third root of negative 27 raised to the fourth power. So let's work in the parentheses first. The third root of negative 27 is going to give us negative 3. And now we're going to raise that to the fourth power. And so negative 3 to the fourth power is going to give us positive 81. Remember that a negative base raised to an even exponent will always give you a positive answer. Now, we want to change this to a radical expression, but first notice that we have a negative exponent. So we want to make that exponent positive before we rewrite it into a radical expression. So that's going to be 1 over 64 to the positive 2/3. Now we can change that to a radical expression. So that's going to be 1 over the third root of 64 raised to the second power. Let's evaluate in the parentheses first. So we have the third root of 64 is going to be 4. And then it's 4 squared in the denominator. And then finally, 4 squared equals 16, so your answer is 1 over 16. To start this off, we want to make sure and make our exponent positive before we write it as a radical expression. So also notice that the base for this negative exponent is the 81. It does not include the negative. Doesn't include that. If it did, then it would need to be in parentheses. Then the base would be the entire negative 81. But this does not have parentheses, so that means that the base is simply the 81. So when we rewrite it as a radical expression, then we want to write it in this way. That'll be negative 1 over 81 raised to the positive 3 over 4. Now we can change it to a radical expression. So that would be negative 1 over the 4th root of 81 raised to the 3rd power. Let's deal with the 4th root of 81 first. So we have negative 1 divided by the 4th root of 81 equals 3. So we have 3 to the 3rd power in the denominator. And then finally, 3 to the 3rd power is 27, so the final answer is negative 1 over 27. Now for this problem, notice that they have negative 100 in parentheses. So that's to let you know that the negative 100 is the base of this negative exponent. So when we rewrite it to get a positive exponent, we want to bring the negative down with the base. We want to include it. So let's go ahead and rewrite it to get a positive exponent. So since we have this entire base that we need to take with us in the denominator, we're going to leave a 1 at the top over negative 100 raised to the positive 3 over 2. Now we can change that to a radical expression. So that's 1 over the square root of negative 100 raised to the 3rd power. Now, we cannot have the square root of a negative number. That's going to give us an imaginary number that's not in the real number system. So because of this, that tells us we are not going to have a real number. So we're not going to try to continue because we only want answers in the real number system.